number 7 are the main annual school trade services. Those are the ones that, if you like, that contribute towards the £9 million. Sitting behind all of this is a business plan for 2013-16 which has been sent out to all schools by Westcom. And then the final bit in terms of background is just to mention that this is now managed as a full-cost recovery trade service under the snappily titled Assistant Chief Executive slash Head of University Infrastructure Services, who sat in front of me, David Armstrong. They kindly asked me to sort of run that on his behalf. So that's the important part behind this, and the principle behind it is to bring school trade services under one umbrella organisation, managed through schools by the local authority, and giving you autonomy and say in terms of how that's run. And ensuring consistency, coherence, and openness and transparency around those particular services. Just as if, moving on to the governance structure on page 87, there are three things I wanted to point out to you here. To use the analogy of a school governing body, the WECS management board at the top is, if you like, is the equivalent of the full governing body, and that's made up of head teachers, governors, and local authority staff, if you like, to make the, provide a strategic lead and decision, key decision making for WECS as it goes forward. And that's for all school trade services that come through WECS from the council. And that's all trade services, not just those run through the Children and People Department. Sitting underneath it are two main subcommittees, which is the EQ Management Board, and then next to that is the Additional Services Management Board, and that again, those have head teacher and governor reps and local authority staff. It was felt to have the subcommittees because of the amount of work that we're asking schools, and particularly their teachers on those particular panels, to do around this particular aspect of work in terms of WECS. Recently, it's been agreed that Oakland's, and we still get to finalise this, but the CLCs and music will also come under WECS as well. So those are the governance structures. And then finally, on page 88, just to briefly run through some of the developments that are taking place. Recently, it was announced by the Chief Executive of the Council that the professional services, shared services, was to be put on hold in the Cheshire West and Chester. However, we are still continuing exploring the possibilities around shared services and school training services with our colleagues over at Cheshire West and Chester. So that's what 3.1 is. And at the moment, if you like, everything that's under WECS is for consideration. It doesn't necessarily mean everything under WECS will ultimately end up in whatever this may become, because no decisions have been formally made around that yet. Linked to that is that Wirral and Cheshire West and Cheshire West and Chester were very successful in a joint bid to the Department of Communities and Local Government, delivering differently, essentially one of the 10 successful bids, which allowed us to get up to £100,000 worth of professional support in terms of developing a shared service approach, looking at possibly going towards a company. As it says there, workshops, access to advisory panel, networking events. This isn't money that comes into the council. This pays for, if you like, it's for consultancy in kind. But it does put us on the national map and national agenda for observation in terms of how we're going forward with protection around this, around shared services. The important one thing to mention, particularly to Schools Forum, is that part of the successful bid included the phrase about developing a mutual approach for if we are to go forward with the company, not only involving both the two councils as stakeholders in the new business, but also schools. And I think that was the thing that in particular attracted the DCLG as a new way of working. Yet to be determined, of course, but it was part of a successful bid. Two other things to note for the Schools Forum. We are rapidly developing two training services offers ready for September. One is which is around metro catering, and in particular, the implications from the universal infant free school meals. Again, we'll be using the WECS board for consultation around that, and development of that. And then secondly as well, in line with a budget option that was taken by the council, about developing a further advancement on the education social welfare service. At the moment that service is offered a trade service to our academy schools. We'll be looking to further that out to all of our maintained schools as well, to see whether schools are interested in purchasing back some of the resources that may go into the budget option taken by the council. Finally, the other thing as well, there's a lot of work being undertaken at the moment, getting ready for April 2015. Most of the service level agreements that are listed previously, the main annual ones, are ready for renewal from April 2015. So we've actually been in a process of renewing in consultation with our schools about reviewing, redesigning, and putting out for consultation and finally offering out to schools a whole range of new service level agreements. Something very similar to what we've currently got, if that's what schools continue to wish to pay for, then we need to see a lot of changes there, and typically we've done it themselves. And that's a lot of work ready for implementation from April 2015.
Part drilled down further into the applications of the application of personal budgets and actually how we reach agreement with families and where appropriate. Chair, I can assure you that information will be provided. Discuss requirements at all locations.
capacity, but over the years, as Prime Minister has gone now, the only one of the bus you have been replaced is still not having two around the three. There's a whole problem with that equipment back. So at the moment, we don't see that we will not be able to do this matter. Meantime.